The week started with a commitment by Parliament to champion mental health awareness, where the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, called for periodical mental resting for Ugandans, including members of Parliament.
You need to do the mental health checks, and we really don't need to do it only on the security personnel. We need to do all of us. We need to do mental health on all of us. In the budget that we have just passed, we have included money for mental health.
Parliament okayed the government to install digital trackers in motor vehicles following a report by the Joint Committee of Defence and Internal Affairs and Physical Infrastructure, which approved the project with strong recommendations of reform.
We observe that these are not in line with the Road Safety Act of 1998, Traffic and Road Safety Act of 1998, and therefore there is a need for harmonization of these findings.
Parliament also received the much-anticipated report of the Presidential Affairs Committee on the misallocation of relief items meant to benefit the people of Karamoja. The report recommended the prosecution of Minister for Karamoja Affairs, Honourable Mary Goretti Chitutu, her Deputy Honourable Agnes Nandutu, and the State Minister for Finance, Honourable Amos Lugolowi, for the mismanagement of relief items meant for vulnerable persons in Karamoja. But it wasn't debated by Parliament on grounds of sub judice.
The Director of Public Prosecutions prosecutes the Minister for Karamoja Affairs, Honourable Dr. Mary Goretti Chitutu, for the following offences: A. Corruption contrary to Section 2CF and H of the Anti-Corruption Act 2009. Director of Public Prosecution prosecutes the Minister of State for Karamoja Affairs, Honorable Nandutu, for the following offences: A. Corruption contrary to Section 2CF and H of the Anti-Corruption Act. Director of Public Prosecutions prosecutes Honorable Amos Lugolobi for the offences of loss of public property contrary to Section 10(3) of the Anti-Corruption Act 2009.
The matter shall be considered sub judice if it refers to active criminal or civil proceedings. In the opinion of the Speaker, the discussion of such a matter is likely to prejudice its fair determination.
The matter of the said expired degrees, which was sparked by the National Council for Higher Education, has been a center of controversy through the week, and the Minister of State for Higher Education, John C. Muyingo, and the Attorney General, Kiryowa Chwanuka, were on the floor this week to allay fears of Ugandans on the matter.
Assesses the quality and relevance of the program and its learning outcomes, as well as the teaching and learning methods. Institutions are required to resubmit programs for the reassessment every 5 years for those who are doing masters.
Still this week, Parliament has passed the Employment Amendment Bill 2022 that will see casual labourers who have served for 6 continuous months deemed to have a valid contract. Legislators, however, rejected the proposal that would have seen maternity leave increased from 60 to 90 days.
There has been a lot of issues raised. So this bill seeks to regulate the companies that employ Ugandans and integrate it in the new law. While we had the regulations was not anchored in the law.
High-profile politicians involved in the recruitment of our children for this kind of employment.
This week, the government mysteriously withdrew a financing request of 2 trillion shillings from Amarong Capital Limited and a sovereign infrastructure group after it was rejected by the Parliamentary Committee on National Economy. The committee scrutinized the agreement and raised concerns regarding tax waivers on interest and fees, as well as the increasing waiver of sovereign immunity.
Move to amend the motion is on 2 grounds. One ground is that given the time we have not been able to gather all the information that is required to justify why this company should get should get this arrangement.
The session came to a conclusion by a proclamation of the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, that was read to Parliament by her deputy, Thomas Taewa, prolonging business of Parliament with effect from 25th of May 2023. Report compiled by Fred Kajiwi for the news.